Good morning, everyone. Let us start with today's session. So this is the lecture number 10 of the Engineering Mechanics. In this lecture, we will discuss the parallel force system and the resultant calculation for the parallel force system. And also, we will study the Varignon's theorem for the moment. So what is meaning of parallel force system? As we already discussed in the force classification, so parallel force system, it is the part of coplanar force system where all the forces acting are exactly parallel to each other. So forces can be acting in the vertical direction or forces can be in the horizontal direction. But condition is all the forces must be parallel to each other. So here you can see a simple example. So this is the bench and there are number of forces acting on the bench. The first is 500 Newton. Then 400 Newton, 600 Newton and 700 Newton. Okay. So these all the forces, they form a parallel force system because each force is parallel to each other. So in the parallel force system calculation, we need to find out the net effect of these forces. So what is meaning of net effect? So net effect of the forces is nothing but the resultant R. Okay. So as we already discussed, the resultant calculation for the concurrent force system. So for the concurrent force system, we have the formula for the resultant. R is equal to square root summation fx square plus summation fy square. So first we have to find out the summation fx, then summation fy. And then by using this formula R, we can find out the net effect, that is called as resultant. But in case of parallel force system, either summation fx or summation fy will be zero. Why it is zero? If you observe this diagram, okay, in this diagram, all the forces are acting in y direction only. Okay, so which component for these forces will be zero, whether it is fx zero or fy zero? So as all the forces acting in the y direction, that means the x component of the forces will be zero. And only for the resultant, we have to consider the y component. Therefore, we can directly write down summation fx for this system, it will be zero. And the resultant R is equal to square root summation fx square plus summation fy square. So as fx square is zero, so square root of summation fy square, it will be only R is equal to summation fy. Okay. So just for the parallel force system, if the forces are acting in the y direction, so we can consider this is a y direction and this is your x direction. So if the all forces are acting in the y direction, then we can write down R is equal to summation fy only. And if all the forces are acting in x direction only, then the resultant R, that is called as a net effect, it is equal to summation fx only. So you have to remember this formula for the parallel force system. If the forces are acting in the y direction, then R is equal to summation fy. And for x direction, R is equal to summation fx. So I hope this point is clear, how to find out the resultant of the system. Now just observe the given force system where on this bench, the four forces are acting. Their values are 500 Newton, 400 Newton, 600 Newton, and 700 Newton. All the forces are acting in the negative y direction. So this is your minus y direction. So the resultant, we can write down, R is equal to summation fy only. So just use the same sign convention. If the forces are acting in the negative direction, we will consider this as a minus. So this is minus 500, then minus 400, minus 600, and minus 700 newton. So their summation will be R is equal to, this is 2200 newton, and this is minus. So this minus sign, it indicates the force magnitude is 2200 newton, and the direction of this force, that is nothing but the resultant, it is towards the negative y direction. So this is your answer. R is equal to 2200. Okay. So if you want to show this force on this diagram, then this is the resultant and the value is 2200 newton. Okay. So compared to concurrent force system calculation, the calculation for parallel force system is easy. Okay. So just we have to use any one equation, summation Fy or summation Fx. Now the second part here, we want to locate the resultant with respect to any one point. So suppose this is the point A, that is the left support, and on the right side point is B. So with respect to any one point, we need to locate the resultant, and for that we have to find out the distance D. Locate the resultant means what? We have to find out the distance of that resultant, that is R, with respect to any one point in the system. So in case of concurrent force system, as we already studied, okay, suppose this is the point and number of forces are acting at this point. Let us take this 50. This is 20. This is 30. And this is 50 newton. And suppose we want to find out the resultant of this system. Okay. So this point is point O. This is called as a point of concurrency. So for such type of system, that is for the concurrent force system, we know the exact position of the resultant. As all the forces are acting at the point O, that means the resultant, it must act at the same point. Okay. So in such type of problem, there is no need to find out the distance. So if I want to show the resultant on this system, then it may be somewhere here. So this will be the value of resultant, and the location will be exactly at the point O only. Okay. But in case of parallel force system, we need to find out this location. That means we have to find out the distance D with respect to any one point. Okay. So that is the difference between a parallel force system and the concurrent force system. Okay. So I hope this point is clear. How to find out this distance D, that we will study later. Now parallel force system, the practical application of this system is the first example here for the suspension bridge. So all of you must have seen suspension bridge. Okay. So suspension bridge, the load of the concrete and the load of the vehicle, okay, so this load of the concrete and load of the vehicle, they will form a parallel force system. So if you observe this diagram, then you can understand what is meaning of parallel force system and what is the practical application. So this green line, we can consider this as a beam. Okay, on this beam, these are the forces, or we can say these are the weight of the vehicles on that bridge. This is W1, W2, then W3, as well as there will be a load of the cement concrete so this is the representation of that load. Okay, so this system from the mathematical analysis or from the mechanics point of view, we can call this system as a parallel force system. Okay, so I hope you understand the practical application of the parallel force system. So this is one of the application. The second application, it is in the vehicle design or the automobile design. So in the vehicle design, so this is one example of the truck. So this container, has some weight. Let us take this as a W, okay? And when we design the chassis, so this steel frame, this is called as a chassis, okay? So it is basically the skeleton of this truck. So when we design this chassis, we need to consider the load by this container and by the auxiliary components. And by considering this load of container and the auxiliary component, we need to design the chassis of that truck, okay, which will support the all load because of the container and the auxiliary component. So during this calculation, so this is this chassis. You must have seen this chassis. So basically, this is a steel structure. So this is called as a chassis. So when we design these components, we need to design these frames. So for the frame design, we need to find out the dimensions of this frame. And when we design or find out the dimensions, we need to consider the load supported by this frame. So this load is nothing but the load of the container and load of the auxiliary of that truck, and the system is considered as a parallel force system. So here you can see how the forces will act on this chassis. Okay, so these forces are nothing but the, these are the weight of the container or weight of the auxiliary components. So here you can see this is the container. Okay, suppose it carries some material. Okay, maybe sand or any other material, then that material including the weight of this container will be distributed over this chassis like this. Okay, so this forms a parallel force system. So I hope this concept is clear, what is meaning of parallel force system and what is the practical application. So is there any doubt up to this step? If you have any doubt, you can directly ask. So just give the reply, then I will proceed for the next calculation. Now, as we have discussed in the first example, when we find out the resultant for the parallel force system, then we need to find out the distance of that resultant with respect to any one point of that system. And for that, we will use one theorem. And this theorem is called as a Varignas theorem. Okay, so what is the statement of the Varignas theorem? As you can see here, the algebraic sum, of the moments by the system of coplanar forces about any point is equal to the moment by the resultant about the same point. Okay, so what is meaning of this statement? Just assume one parallel force system. So assume this is the beam AB, and the number of forces are acting on this beam. So suppose first is 100 Newton, then 200 Newton, and next is 300 Newton. Okay, so three forces are acting at three different locations. So let us take this point C. This is point D, and this is the point E. So distance between A and C, let us take this is 1 meter. This is 1 meter. This is 2 meter, and this is again 2 meter. So total span of the beam AB, it is equal to 6 meter. Okay. Now question is, for this parallel force system, we have to find out the resultant R and distance of this resultant. With respect to point A. Okay, so let us take this distance as a D, which is the unknown distance, and by using a calculation, we have to find out the distance D. So first step is we have to find out the resultant R. As this is parallel force system, that means resultant R, it is equal to summation Fy only. Why we are considering summation Fy? As all the forces are acting in the y direction. If the forces are acting in the x direction, we can consider R is equal to summation Fx. Okay. So now for this system, the resultant R, we can take this is minus 100, then minus 200, minus 300. And this is equal to minus 600 Newton. Okay. So minus 600 means what? This is 600 Newton in the downward direction. Okay. So this is the value of resultant. Now the question is, where we will show this resultant on the beam AB. And for that, we have to find out the distance D. And to find out the distance D, we need to use the Varignas theorem. Okay. So let us assume the position of the resultant anywhere on this beam AB. So right now we don't know what is the exact location. So just assume somewhere on this beam AB at distance D with respect to point A, our resultant R will lie. So this is the R and this is the distance D with respect to point A. So this value R is equal to 600 Newton. Do not consider this as a minus 600, because as we show the arrow in the downward direction, that means it is 600 Newton. And in the calculation, we need to take this as a minus sign. Okay. So in the direction, do not show the negative sign. Direction means it is a negative sign. Okay. So now refer the Varignas theorem. What does this Varignas theorem says? The algebraic sum of the moment by this system of coplanar forces. So what is meaning of system? We need to observe the original system. That is a system of forces. That means system considering 100 Newton, 200 Newton and the 300 Newton. Okay. So find out the summation of moment by these three forces. So I will just write down summation of the forces summation of moment by the system of forces so this summation we will take about the point A so here moment by all the forces about the point A so this is nothing but the summation of moment that is equal to now first take 100 newton and take the moment by 100 newton about the point A so what is the moment force into this perpendicular distance so here 100 into this perpendicular distance is 1 meter and this moment it is in the clockwise direction so how do we decide the direction fix the point A okay and just apply 100 newton forget about the remaining forces okay only consider 100 newton is acting on the beam AB so effect of 100 newton will be it will try to rotate this system in the clockwise direction about the point A so therefore it is minus 100 into 1 then consider the 200 newton so force is 200 into perpendicular distance is 2 meter and again this moment is clockwise about the point A so this is minus next is 300 newton into perpendicular distance is 4 meter and this complete moment is clockwise so it is minus when we take the moment do not consider the sign of the force as the force is acting in downward direction so it is negative okay but do not consider this sign when we consider the moment we need to consider plus or minus force only in the force calculation that is maybe in the summation fy or in the summation fx but in the moment calculation we need to observe the effect of rotation if the effect is clockwise complete moment will be negative and if the effect is anti clockwise complete moment will be positive okay so in this example there is no anti clockwise moment so all the moments by force 100 200 and 300 they are in the clockwise direction okay so this is nothing but the summation of moment by the system of forces okay so we will find out the value so this is 100 this is minus 400 and this is minus 1200 okay so the value is 1700 newton meter okay and now consider the second part of the statement the algebraic sum of the moments by the system of coplanar forces about any point is equal to the moment by the resultant about the same point so this complete value that is summation of moment it is equal to moment by the resultant about the same point so point is point A so take the moment by resultant so this is our resultant 600 newton do not consider this minus 600 in the moment we do not consider the sign of the forces we only consider the direction of the moment okay so 600 into we don't know what is the perpendicular distance with respect to point A so we have assumed this distance as a d so write this distance as it is d and now consider the direction of this moment so this direction is clockwise this resultant it will rotate the system that is a beam AB about the point A in the clockwise direction so this will be minus and now equate this summation of moment by all the forces about the point A is equal to the moment by the resultant about the same point A so this is the Varignon's theorem so this is mathematical expression for the Varignon's theorem moment summation of moment by all the forces about any point in the system is equal to the moment by the resultant about the same point. So we will equate these two values, minus 1700 and minus 600 into d. So we have the equation summation of moment by all the forces about point A is equal to moment by the resultant about the same point A. So this value is minus 1700. It is equal to minus 600 into distance D. So minus minus, we can cancel out. So remaining value D is equal to, it is 1700 divided by 600. Okay, so we can get the value of D. So this answer is 2.83 meter. Okay, so how to show this 2.83? So this is our original system, that is called as a system of forces. So this is the beam AB. So these are the forces. First is 100 Newton, 200 Newton, and 300 Newton. Now, when you find out the resultant, we need to replace this system by the resultant force. So this is our resultant system. So for the resultant system, just draw the original beam AB. And remove all these forces, 100, 200 and 300. Just show the resultant. Okay, so resultant distance is 2.83. that means somewhere it will be between D and E point. So I will show the resultant here. So this is the R value, that is equal to 600 Newton, and this distance with respect to point A, this is D, is equal to 2.83. So this is the resultant force system. Okay, so in order to find out the position of the resultant, we need to use the Varignon's theorem. Okay, so I hope this point is clear, how to find out the resultant of the parallel force system. So for the resultant, so for the resultant calculation, in case of parallel force system, step is find out summation fx or summation fy. If the forces are acting in the x direction, just find out summation fx, and for y direction, find out the summation fy. Then you can use the formula, r is equal to either summation fx or r is equal to summation fy. And then to find the location of the resultant, with respect to any point, use the Varignon's theorem. Okay, so Varignon's theorem, mathematical equation, summation of moment about any point by the system of forces is equal to the moment by the resultant about the same point. So I hope this complete calculation is clear. If you have any doubt, then you can directly ask. Okay, so this is one given system. So this statement is a transmission tower supports four cables and the tension forces on the tower are shown in the figure. Okay, determine the resultant R of the system and its location with respect to base of the tower. So in the last example, the system given was the parallel force system and the forces were acting in the y direction only. Now in this system, the forces are acting in x direction only. So the forces are F1 is 2000, F2 is 3000, then F3, this is 200 and F4 is 800 Newton. So when we solve this problem, this transmission tower, just we can assume a simple line or simple vertical line. Like this, okay. Take this base as a point A. This is the point B. And then show the forces acting. This is 2000 Newton. Then next is 3000 Newton. This is 200. And this is 800 Newton. So for the resultant, we will use the equation R is equal to summation Fx. As all the forces acting in the x direction only. So your R value will be 2000, this is positive x direction, plus 3000, then minus 200 and minus 800. Okay, so this is 5000 minus 1000. So resultant will be 4000 Newton. And as the value is positive, that means direction, it is towards the positive x direction. Okay, so we have got the answer for resultant. Now we have to locate the resultant. So for the location of the resultant, we need to apply the Varignon's theorem about the given point. So here we have to locate with respect to the base of the tower. So base point we have assumed as a point A. So we will use the Varignon's theorem. About point A. So the equation will be summation of the moment by all the forces about the point A is equal to the moment by the resultant about the same point A. So this is the Varignon's theorem about the point A. So all the distances are given. So we will first write the summation of forces. So this is a system of forces. Then once we get the value of resultant, we will replace it by the system of resultant. Okay. So we have got the value 4000. So this is the resultant system. So right now we don't know what is the distance of resultant with respect to point A, but we know the direction. So resultant R is equal to 4000 Newton. Okay. and it is acting towards the positive x direction. So we will assume somewhere here, this is the resultant R, that is equal to 4000 newton, and take the distance d with respect to point A. Right now we don't know what is the exact value. Okay, so this equation or this diagram we will use for the Varignon's theorem. So Varignon's theorem is summation of moment by all the forces about point A is equal to the moment by the resultant about the point A. So from this, just write down summation of moment. So start from the 2000. So 2000 into its perpendicular distance. So this total distance is given as a 10 meter into 10. Now observe the effect of rotation. So if you apply this 2000 Newton at this point, okay, then this 2000 Newton, it will rotate this complete tower in the clockwise direction about the point A. So this moment will be minus. Then second force is 3000 into this perpendicular distance is 8 meter. And again, it will rotate the system in clockwise direction. So this is minus. Then next is 200 into this distance, it is equal to 6 meter. And this moment is anti-clockwise. Because the force is acting here, it will rotate the system in the anti-clockwise direction about the point A. So this is plus. Next is 800. And distance is 4 meter. And this will rotate the system in the anti-clockwise direction. So it is positive. Is equal to moment by resultant about the point A. So observe the resultant. This is 4000. Into perpendicular distance d, and this resultant, it will rotate the system in the clockwise direction, therefore it is minus. Now find out this total value. So this is equal to 39,600, and this is minus is equal to minus 4000 into D. So D is equal to, this is 9.9 meter. That means your resultant as this is 10 meter. So somewhere here, the resultant will lie. So this is R is equal to 4000. And this distance, it is equal to 9.9. with respect to the point A. Okay, so just check this answer if there is mistake. So have you understood this problem, how to use the Varignon's theorem?
Yes sir.
So the application of Varignon's theorem is, in case of parallel force system or in case of general force system, we can find out the position of the resultant with respect to given point in the system. So that is the application of Varignon's theorem. So I hope you understood this problem. Okay, so we will solve one problem on the excavator arm. Just draw this diagram. Okay, so this is the given system. So in this system, this excavator arm carries a load of the pipe. So this load value W, it is equal to 500 kg. So we want to lift this load by using this excavator arm. Okay, so four cables are connected in order to support this load, that is a pipe of weight 500 kg, and one extra cable is connected at this end point A. So this cable, it pulls this complete arm by applying a 6000 Newton force. Now we want to find out what is the resultant value and what is the location of the resultant with respect to point B. Okay, so is the problem clear to you? So there are four cables. These cables are connected at points C, D, E, and F of this arm. This cable lifts the pipe of weight 500 kg. Another cable is connected at the point A in the upward direction. This cable pulls this complete arm by applying 6000 Newton force. Now we have to find out what is the resultant and what is the point of application. So can we solve this problem? So I will explain the initial steps. This I will erase this part. We are interested in this arm only. So when we solve the problem, then we will simplify the given arm as a plane beam. Okay, so plane beam means what? You can just draw one single line. So this is the line. So this is the point B and this is the point A. Now at point A, this is the force that is equal to 6000 Newton. This is point C, D, E, and F. Actually, in this cable, forces are not visible, but we know the direction. These forces will be acting in the downward direction. Okay, so we will show these forces like this, exactly in the y direction, that is a negative y direction. And what is the value of the forces in this cable? Can anyone tell the answer? What is the value of force developed in the cable? Is it equal to 500 kg? Just give me the exact value. Force in each cable. Is it equal to 500 kg? The value of force in each cable, it will be equal to, F is equal to, we need to convert this load. Actually, it is given in kg. So this is a mass. So we need to multiply by gravity. So it will become a weight. So that is equal to 500 into 9.81 divided by 4. So four cables are connected. So in each cable, load will be weighed by 4. Okay. So this value will be 1226.25 Newton. So this is the value of force in each cable. This is 6000 Newton. Now this distance are given along this axis of this arm. So each distance is 50 centimeter. Okay. So take this distance 50 centimeter. And this angle with respect to horizontal it is given as a 30 degree. Okay, so this is the system. So this is a simplified system of the actual system. So this is called as a physical system, and this is the its equivalent model for the calculation. Now we have to find out the resultant and its location D with respect to point B. Okay, so can we solve this problem? So try to solve this as a homework. Okay, so we will see the complete answer in the next lecture. Is there any doubt? If you have any doubt, you can directly ask.